would be a good job for you, Charlie Brown. You'd make a great student body president.
No, I've already taken a poll, and my poll shows that Charlie Brown could never be elected. There's no way anyone would say you're elected, Charlie Brown, because there's no way you could ever be elected. So we'll just have to find another candidate.
How about Linus? I bet he'd do something about those stupid lockers.
Well, I don't know, but I'll take another poll and find out. If my brother Linus were running for student body president, would you vote for him?
How can I help?
Sure,
I'd vote
for him. I'm going to work on him getting back in his peanut butter sandwich. That's what freedom would be getting lunch.
If you knew that Linus Lindfelt were running for student body president, would you vote for him? No. If you knew that he were going to solve all the problems of the world, would you vote for him?
No.
But why not?
Because I'm the one who's running against him.
I think, Rena, according to my poll, there's no way we can lose.
Fellow classmates, I have great pleasure in introducing the first candidate for student body president, Linus Van Pelt.
Greetings, everyone. If I'm elected, I promise to do many things. First of all, we will receive new lockers. Secondly, there will be more playground equipment. And finally, there will be no more liver served in the cafeteria.
Thank you, Linus. And now, the next candidate for student body president, Russell Anderson.
Hello, my name is Russell Anderson, and if I'm elected, I will do the best I can. Thank you.
That's the worst speech I've ever heard. Now I know we're going to win.
Campaign. Therefore, I have a little surprise for you. Rather than bore you with more campaign talk, I have decided that today I would say a few words about the Great Pumpkin.
Oh, you blockhead! There was no way we could lose until now.
We had it won for sure.
But now we'll be lucky if we get half the vote.
Another vote for Linus. Russell. Linus. Russell. 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 Linus. Linus. Russell. 83 votes for Linus and 83 votes for Russell. There's one person left to vote.
We're doomed!
One more vote for Linus!
I think he will make a better president than I would.
Yay!
Now you can do all the things you promised me, Linus. You have authority. grade academic gifted students in East River Central Elementary on February 1985. The players were Miss Sophomore Robbie Abner, Sally Serena Ursich, Snoopy Ryan Brown, Woodstock Pam Smith, Boy 1 Marshall Spain, Boy 2 Tony B, Russell Anderson Trey Williams, Linus Michael Thrash, Lucy Stacy Tatum, and Charlie Brown Norris Truly Troy Kane. Hi, I'm your time capsule interviewer. I'm here with my assistant, Shannon Jones. We'll be interviewing people on this tape, so happy viewing. It's May 21st, 1985. Welcome, I'm your time capsule interviewer, Troy Kane. Today, I'll be interviewing my assistant, Shannon Jones. Shannon, I'm going to ask you a few questions, okay? What's your favorite food?
I like chicken.
Chicken? Why do you like chicken so much? If you could change the world, what would you change?
Oh, I'd change the way people would run. I'd change, actually, the amount of people that polluted and did things that would hurt the earth.
Okay, I'm sorry. What kind of music do you like?
Soft rock and roll.
Who's your favorite group?
Cool,
yeah. What are some of the songs they sing?
What's your favorite actor?
My favorite actor? Michael Douglas.
What's your favorite actress?
Mia Cattery.
Thank you, this has been Shannon Jones. And we'll get it with Shannon tomorrow. I'm Shannon Jones here with Jennifer Taylor on May 21st at East Bay Central. Jenny, I'm going to ask you a few questions. What is your biggest problem with your parents?
Money, and they think I'm too young to go out with, like, my friends, without the things going on.
Okay. And what is your favorite food, Jenny?
Pizza.
Well, what's your favorite food? Here on May 21st with Jamie Baldwin, a fourth grader at East Deborah Central. Jamie, I'm going to ask you a few questions. What is your favorite group? do you think the things will be like when the house is open? Do you think they will be the same?
No, I think they'll be different because I think the computer age will take over.
What is your favorite book?
Benjamin Franklin.
What's your favorite food?
Broccoli.
Do you like the things that we have in the age? Do you like the things that we're coming up with?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Thank you, Bobby. Shannon Jones here at East River Central Elementary with Susan Carter on May 21st. Susan, I want to ask you a few questions. What do you think about the time capsule being buried?
Well, I think it's a big experience for the Institute Service at the school because as far as I've been here, there hasn't been anything like this in this room.
May 21st, and I'm here with Carrie Adney. Carrie, I'm going to ask you a few questions. What is your favorite foreign country?
Let's see. What's called?
I think Norway.
Norway?
Yes.
Okay. What do you think about the time capsule being buried?
I think it's very interesting and it's very educational for people and I think all the people that see it open in 30 years will be very proud of us being there.
Okay. So what are your favorite subjects in school?
I think math and spelling.
Thank you, Carrie.
Things probably be all mechanics and computer and robotic and everything will be automatic. But in 2015, the kids that come to this school still here, they might not even know that there was an AG class because there might not be one in that year. But with us here in this council, if they do find it, then they might know a little bit something else.
Okay, thank you, Cheryl. Hello, I'm here on May 21st with Wendy Carter, a fifth grader at East Jefferson Elementary. Wendy, I'm going to ask you a question. What are your favorite pastimes in the afternoon after school?
Reading. Lisa, I'm going to ask you a few questions.
Question time.
What is your favorite author of the book?
Judy Blaine.
Okay. What is your favorite pastime in the Astrolabe?
Reading.
Is that your only
one? All right.
Shooting basketball.
Basketball?
That's all you don't know.
What do you think about the castle being there?
Well, I think it would be a success if people find out about it. I liked it, in my opinion.
Thank you, Lisa. I'm here with Brian Pierce, fifth grader, on May 21st at East River Central. Brian, what's your favorite pastime in the afternoon?
Well, I like to eat and then I go over to my friend's house.
Okay. What's your favorite foreign country?
Japan.
What do you like most about the technology in our time right now in the 80s?
Well, what I would like to see improved is space rockets and space shows, but I'm glad they've got already what they've got, like space rockets, space shows, so you can go to the moon and they come back and make more.
Okay. Thank you, Brian. Hello, I'm Shanna Jones here with Jason Perot, a fourth grader, on May 21st at East River Central. Jason, I'm going to ask you a few questions. What's your favorite food?
I think pizza would be it.
Okay. What's your favorite author of books?
Biblical.
You like biblical? Okay. What do you think would be the best change that they could do by the time that the passage?
May 22nd, 1985. Welcome. I'm your time capsule interviewer, Troy Kane. I'm here with fellow AG student and fellow sixth grader, Leah Autry. Leah, I'm going to ask you a few questions, okay? Okay. What's your favorite food?
Pizza.
Why pizza?
Well, I like the way it tastes. I like Italian food, and that's one of my favorite
foods. If you could change anything in the world, what would you change?
I think I'd change the condition in Africa. I'd let all the children that don't have any food have some.
Okay, if you could visit any foreign place, what foreign country would you visit?
I think I'd like to visit Japan.
Japan, why Japan?
Because it's so exotic, I think.
Okay, if you can change anything about yourself, what would you change?
Well, I think I'd be a little more outgoing. Sometimes I'm kind of, you know, shy.
Okay. Well, thank you, Leah.
Goodbye.
May 22nd, 1985. Hello, I'm your time capsule reviewer, Troy Kane. I'm here with a fellow sixth grader and fellow AT student, Troy Kane. Mike Fussell. Mike, I'm going to ask you a few questions, okay?
Okay.
okay. What's your favorite food?
Pizza.
Oh, pizza.
Like the cheese and pepperoni.
Okay. Why do you like the cheese and pepperoni?
Just do.
Okay. If you died and you could come back to Earth in any other form, what would you come back as?
Another person.
I know, male or female?
Male.
I didn't know. Okay. If you could visit any foreign place, what foreign place would you visit?
Possibly Africa.
Africa, why?
Well, to see. I bet the stolen children are doing it. See how we can
about yourself that you changed?
Nothing.
Okay. Well, thank you, Mike. May 22nd, 1985. Hello. Today I'm interviewing Philip Fairclough, a fellow sixth grader and fellow AG student.
Philip, can I ask you a few questions, okay?
Okay. If you died and could come back to Arthur in any form, what would you come back to?
Myself.
That's why.
I would want
you. You want to change the GMA off. You want to come back as Philip Fairclough. Okay. What kind of thing? Do you collect things?
Let's go.
What do you
got? The worms. Do you sell them? We get some money.
Okay. How much are they worth?
Beans. Different farms. Different companies.
Okay. What is your idea of smog?
Somebody stuck up.
Yes. What do you mean by stuck up?
Somebody that always tries to push you down or, you know, doesn't, you know, think you're doing any good even though you're trying your best or something.
Okay, if you could visit any foreign place, what where would you visit?
Holland.
Holland's my home.
Because I like, you know, all the waterways and, you know, all those and stuff like that.
Thank you, Philip. May 22nd, 1985. Hello, I'm interviewing fellow sixth grade and fellow AG student, Wayne Page. Wayne, I'm going to ask you a question.
Yes.
Okay. If you could come back as anything in, you know, in any form after you died, what would you come back as?
Me.
Why you?
Because I like you.
Because you like you.
Yes.
Okay. If you could change anything about yourself, what would you change? You change.
I got ladies.
You change the ideas. Okay. What's your idea of a snob?
Somebody's stuck up. They don't have anything to do with them.
What do you mean by stuck up?
What I mean is they're stuck up. Well, what I mean is like if you were good by and say something, they just stick up your nose.
Well, you know, didn't say anything to you. Because
he's driving back
again. Yeah. Okay. What is your idea of a friend?
Somebody to talk to, but don't really talk much about.
If you could visit any more, if you could visit any foreign place, where would you visit?
Holland. Well, what I mean is, it's peaceful.
It's peaceful.
Yes.
Why do you think it's peaceful?
Yeah.
Why do you think it's peaceful?
I guess the water clouds the room. So.
Thank you, Wayne.
Thank you.
It's May 22nd, 1985. Hello. Today I'm interviewing fellow AG student and fellow sixth grader, Sean Wood. Sean, I'm going to ask you a few questions. What do you want to be when you grow up?
A scientist.
Why do you want to be a scientist?
Because I like to study about, you know, rocks and the water.
To be a geographical scientist. Okay. What do you think of the AG program?
Well, I like it. I like getting out of class.
Okay. What else do you like about it?
I like doing work in it, like get to make what you're being going to.
Okay. If you could change anything about yourself, what would you change?
gets in the way.
What's your biggest problem with
him?
Him is your biggest problem. Okay. If you could change anything about yourself, what would you change?
I might get about 3 inches taller.
Okay. What do you think of the time capsule?
It's alright. I'd like I heard somebody else say that. I think it's be fun to see me now and see what I'm gonna look like and how things are gonna change by the time that I'm up there 30 years from now.
Okay. What do you think of the aging program?
Well, I like to get out of class and you get to do some fun things like Ms. McCleary lets us check out library books and we do a lot of thinking activities and things like that.
So Ms. McCleary is the AG.
That's right.
Okay. Thank you.
You didn't know Ms. McCleary was the AG?
No. Oh, May 22nd, 1985. Today I'm interviewing fellow AG student Phyllis Sixth Grader Ryan Brown. Now I'm going to ask you some questions, okay?
Okay.
If you could come back as anything, what would you come back as? You know, like if you died.
Probably another
human. Male female. What do you think of the aging program?
I think that it's a very good program for students who have advanced past the classroom level.
Okay. What do you think of the time capsule?
So that the people who are in the future will know about their past.
Okay. Do you have a brother or sister?
A brother.
Is he older or younger? What's your biggest problem? What is one memorable incident? You know, one memorable occasion in your life? Just one memorable occasion.
I'm not born, I guess.
Okay. Thank you, Ryan.
You're welcome.
May 22nd, 1985. Hello, I'm your time capsule in 2014. Hello, I'm interviewing fellow 6th grade and 8th grade students, Robbie Adler.
Last few questions, okay, Robbie?
Where would you visit?
Here,
interviewing fellow AG student and fellow sixth grader, Pam Smith. Pam, I'm going to ask you a question. If you could come back with anything, like you died, you can come back to Earth, what would you come back with?
Well, I'm not sure what I would come back as, but I'd be glad to come back.
Well, you aren't, what would you come back as?
No. Maybe I'd come back as myself.
What's your favorite food?
My favorite food is pizza.
What about pizza?
Because it has so many, you know, enjoyable things I like. Mushrooms and bell peppers and sausage and all that.
Okay. What kind of books do you like to read?
Well, I like to read, like comedy books, like joke books, because I like to laugh a lot, you know.
What do you think of the Asian program?
I think it's real nice because it gives us a chance to get out of the classroom and get rid of all this learning stuff. We have fun in Asian. We have it's a fun program.
Okay, what do you think of the time capsule program?
I think it's going to be exciting. Like real architects is real architecture.
Thank you, Pam. May 22nd, 1985. Hello, today I'm interviewing fellow AG student, fellow sixth grader, Sawyer Ursich.
So I'm going to ask you questions, okay?
What's your favorite animal?
I like monkeys and hedgehogs.
Why?
The monkeys, they're interesting. I mean, they're not like people. They're smart. And hedgehogs are cute.
What did you learn?
Yeah. They're like porcupines without tails.
Okay. if you could visit any foreign country, what country would you visit?
That's a hard question. Let's see, I'd like to go to Greece or Sunday teachers and also the cafeteria food.
Okay, you get some new students to cafeteria. Why would you change teachers?
Well, I think some of them are a little bit too strict and they give kids too much. They can't handle it.
Homework?
Work in general.
Work period. Okay. Do you ever think about yourself or did you change? Did you change
anything? Yeah. I changed my math.
Okay.
I would change. I'm clumsy. I'm always getting hurt.
Okay. Did you change anything about the AG program? Did you change anything?
I don't know. I think I'd like to have more. I don't know. No, I don't think I'd change anything.
And what do you think of the AG program? What were you going to say? What do you think of the AG instructor?
She's funny. She's nice. She expects a lot, so you want to give her more.
Okay. Have you ever been any, like, do you dance or do you actually sing or what?
Well, I think I can sing. I dance. I've been tap and ballet for 8 years. And I was going to try out for Gypsy, but
what
I couldn't make it.
What was Gypsy?
It was a play at Fort Bragg Theater.
That will be in Fort Bragg
Theater.
Okay. I was just learning. Okay. Well, thank you, Sarah.
Yeah.
May 22nd, 1985. Hello. Right now, I'm interviewing fellow sixth grade student and fellow AG student, Cher Williams.
change my personality. Well, not really, because I would like to be a better person, because I know I act snobby to some people, but I don't really mean to.
And you
say
change your personality?
Change
your
personality?
No,
not really. Okay.
If you could visit any foreign land,
what foreign land
would you visit?
I would Japan, because I would like to see the new industry they have over there, because you know they're ahead of us.
You visit Japan?
Uh-huh.
Okay. What kind of books do you like to read?
Science fiction.
Why science fiction?
Because I enjoy reading about what people think is going to happen.
If you could help any cause, what cause would you help?
The African Native people in Ethiopia.
Well, thank you, Trey. Hello, I'm interviewing fellow sixth grade biology student Marshall Spain. Marshall, can I ask you a question? What kind of girl do you like?
What kind of girl?
What kind of a girl do I like? That's a good question. I like girls who can take a joke.
What do you mean?
But like, you know, if you do something like that's supposed to be funny and she takes it the wrong way and slaps it, no, I don't want to go like that.
Okay. So you want a girl who's fun loving and happy to go with you,
right?
Right. Okay. If you died and came back as a girl, reincarnated as a girl, and what would you do? I mean, how would you like, okay, what standards would you set yourself at?
What do you mean?
Like, the standards, like, how would you go out on a date? Say you could make your own rules, and your parents would make your own rules as long as they're reasonable. And like, I'm going to go out with a boy for, you know, 3 hours to make 10 o'clock. What would be your standards? You know, I'm not going to kiss you on the first date. You know this. What would be your standards?
Well, I never really thought about that.
Go ahead.
Well, I'm not sure.
What?
You're
not sure? Okay.
I have no idea.
You have no idea. Okay. If you came back and you could be reincarnated and you could choose what you were reincarnated as, what would you come back? Anything. You know, a pen, paper, anything. Trash can.
Probably the
Egyptian
A tape recorder.
Why a tape recorder?
Because I could hear what everybody was talking about when they were like recording the message. They didn't want anybody to know about it. I'd get to hear what it was.
Okay. Well, thank you, Martha.
You're welcome.
Okay. May 22nd, 1985. Hello, I'm in Top Cap Florida Village Roy Kane. I'm interviewing a fellow sixth grader. I'm going to go with the script. I just did it. Stacy Tatum. Stacy, I'm going to ask you a question.
enjoy them. What is your idea of a snob?
You. No, no, I'm just kidding. My idea of a snob is someone that tries to be the leader all the time and is not open to suggestions. Like if you were in a group and someone tried to be the leader.
Or someone prevents someone from trying to be the leader. Is that what you're talking about? Yeah. Okay.
No. I'm trying to say that if someone goes around with their nose in the air and cuts people off for no reason at all, because they have not done anything to you, or had experiences where people, they start picking on me because of no reason, you know, they just set, they've made up their mind they don't like me, and that's the way they do with a lot of people. That's my idea of a snob.
Okay. What do you think of the AG program?
I think it's wonderful. I think it's a good chance for students who would otherwise be bored with school or would feel like, you know, all they do is just go to school, get out a textbook and sit through their work. It gives them a chance to go and do extra things that really are a challenge to them.
What do you think of the time capsule program?
I think that's real interesting. It's another thing that students can do which will help them to be interested in the AG program.
Do you have a role, like I'm an interviewer, do you have a special role?
What do you mean?
In the program. Okay,
I'm the protocol officer.
What is the protocol officer?
Okay, the protocol officer writes up a speech and then presents it at the ceremony where Mr. Ray, the principal, accepts the maps and everything to the time capsule.
Very, very important. Okay. Thank you, Stacy.
Well.
Hello, I'm your fellow AG student, Matthew Thomas. Matthew, I'm going to ask you questions, okay?
Okay.
What's your favorite food?
Pizza.
Why pizza?
Because it has lots of vegetables.
If you could visit any foreign place, like, you know, any foreign country, what foreign country would you visit?
Japan.
Why Japan?
Because it has many sites and many places to visit.
Okay. What is your idea of a neat boy and girl? Like a neat boyfriend.